We have new information now about the Baker County man accused of stealing military night vision gear due to his access as a Florida National Guard member. We first told you about the arrest of Alan Tanner Jr. yesterday at noon. Action News Jack's Katie McKee is at the Baker County Sheriff's Office now. And Katie, they started investigating Tanner after he was suspected of stealing from the sheriff's family.
Right now, the westbound ramp of I-10 is still closed at this hour as crews work to clean up an oil spill from a semi that overturned on the road. It's one of two breaking semi crashes we've been following since early this morning. We have team coverage this noon. We begin with our Bridget Matter on the westbound ramp of I-10. She shows us the semi driver told officers that he may have dozed off.
Now, just an hour earlier, crews responded to a second crash in I-10, this one along the eastbound stretch near Chafee Road, where a dump truck lost its load, causing a wreck involving a number of vehicles. Action News Jack's Russell Colburn continues our team coverage now with word that lanes will have to be shut down again. Right now, hundreds of families are without gas at Eureka Gardens Apartments because of a busted pipe. We first told you about this last night when the state fire marshal gave an emergency order to shut off the gas because of a dangerous leak Thursday night. Action News' Jack Larry Spool is live in Eureka Gardens right now. And Larry, crews arrived this morning to inspect the pipes at that complex.
We'll have more tonight at 5. Right now, campus police at UNF are investigating a multicultural fraternity's jacket hanging from a noose as a possible hate crime. As we first reported last night, the fraternity has members from 67 different ethnicities. As Action News Jack's Bridget Matter shows us, police say the motive is still unclear.